All right, Harold, so we know from Monday, it's now Wednesday, that your stroke rate on Monday, your average sort of stroke rate, the stroke rate that you tend to feel comfortable with, is about 50 to 52 strokes per minute.
Yeah.
We've just been doing a little refinement to try to stop you overgliding with that left hand especially, and we now know that the stroke rate has come up a little bit. In fact, it's come up quite a bit, probably about 25%, looking much smoother. When you go back down to your older stroke rate, suddenly it feels very, very hard. Now what we're going to do here, we're going to go a stroke rate ramp test. We're going to start off at 45 strokes per minute, which is going to feel very slow. Okay, and we're going to gradually, after each 50 meters, we're going to ramp it up by 3 strokes per minute to see where your optimal stroke rate is actually sitting now. So I'll just fill out this little form here. So 45, 48, 51, 54, 57, 60, 63, 66, which is where you were looking at very, very good just a moment ago, 69, and we'll go up to 72. 72, 75, mid-70s is where Ian Thorpe used to swim at for 400 freestyle. He looked really slow because he had such a long stroke, but the important thing to recognize that he had a long stroke and a fast stroke as well. Okay, so let's see how we go. You just need to swim as best you can, as naturally as possible at that beeper. Okay, you don't need to worry about anything else. Now, just to stop any confusion, let's just take the radio headset off there. So just pull this one off. And then you're just left to your own devices with that beeper. Now, I'm not going to give you any information as you go along. You're simply going to tell me at the end of each 50 meters how hard it felt out of 10. And as you've been finding, going back to some of those slower stroke rates, actually... Say again, sorry? Yeah, exactly right. Hard as in tiring, yeah. So on some of those slower stroke rates, you've already been saying that was a lot more tiring than the higher stroke rate. So, for example, I wouldn't be surprised at all if, you know, on the first couple of steps, it was more like a 6 or a 7, 8 out of 10, and then it got lower as we went along. But obviously, I don't want to put words in your mouth for that. That's all the feedback they've already given me from that. So I'm going to count the number of strokes. I'm going to time you, ask for any specific comments. Otherwise, you're just swimming as naturally as possible. Okay. All right, now, let me just grab the old stopwatch. Here we go. Do you want a little test on this one first? Why don't you just do 10 strokes or so to see what that actually feels like, and then we'll turn around and start it properly. Now notice how much leg kick he's bringing in there. Good. All right, come back to the wall. So what we found with Harold's one-to-one session on Monday was he has this sort of long overglide at the front, but he matched it with a very, very strong leg kick to push him through. And as we know, that becomes very, very tiring and fatiguing indeed. Okay, are you ready with this then? Let's see if this is a little bit of fun. Okay, I'm not going to give you any information as we go along. You're just going to report to me each time. Okay, are you ready? 50 meters and then stop. 2, 1. One strokes per 50 meters. Now there's going to be plenty of people watching this thinking that's an amazing stroke count over 50 meters. The reality is though, it was nearly, well, I'm not supposed to be giving you feedback here, but it was slow. You could probably feel that yourself. You can probably feel how hard you're kicking to go with that. Okay, so I'm just going to make a note of this here. 31 strokes per 50. Interestingly enough, Ian Thorpe, when he was racing 400 meters freestyle, would take 32 strokes per 50 meters. Okay, so that would be considered a very low stroke count. Question is, was it efficient? Okay, no. All right, so I'd like you to just take the beeper out there and just just add 3 strokes per minute to take it to 48 strokes per minute. Out of 10, how hard would you say that was?
Six or seven,
okay. Kicking was so tiring, yeah? Okay. So oftentimes, Harold, when people do these long strokes, take these fewer stroke counts, they're not really aware of how hard they're kicking to sort of push themselves through that dead spot. you're feeling this big time right now. Okay, here we go then. So 48 strokes per minute. Let's give this a go. Look at the massive stall at the front. 7, 8, 9, the big leg kick, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18.
Just relax, you don't need to swim fast.
31. Okay, how was that one? Still quite hard, yeah? Out of 10, same sort of thing, or? 6. Any specific comments about that?
I couldn't balance myself.
Couldn't balance yourself, okay, that's an interesting one all in itself.
I have to use my...
The left hand to balance. And of course, the more you use that left hand to try to balance yourself, the more you're actually applying a braking effect and slowing yourself down. So oftentimes when people couple this really long stroke, they actually tend to get too much rotation. Sometimes they've been taught to literally swim on their side like a fish, okay? But unfortunately, stalling in that position, as you can feel, just lose all your balance. Okay, so let's take it up to 51 now. So this is halfway house. 51 is halfway house between what we saw on Monday. So this is more of your natural stroke rate from Monday morning session, okay? Here we go. When you're ready.
That just started up.
Twenty-five, twenty-six, twenty-seven, twenty-eight, twenty-nine, thirty, thirty-one, thirty-two, and a glide in. Okay.
Let's go, roll them out, nice and fast.
Now, you probably noticed with Harold's stroke there, when you're kicking, because you're just literally trying to push yourself, can you feel it now, how you're trying to push yourself through that dead spot? All this effort in the leg kick, a lot of it's actually just been wasted to a big splash. And it's quite evident on that last lap there how you're actually kicking very, very hard to sort of push yourself through that point. Okay, mate, so let's add up to bring it up to 54 now then. Out of 10, was that one a bit better, would you say?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah? A bit better? Out of 10?
10 seconds.
About a 5, okay. 5 or a 6. That's obviously quite subjective, so it's up to, there's no right or wrong with that, it's just how you're sort of generally feeling. Okay, let's give this a go now then. Twenty-five, twenty-six, twenty-seven, twenty-eight, twenty-nine, thirty, one, two, and three. Okay, how's that one?
That was harder for some reason.
Harder for some reason? Okay, interesting. Okay, now we're up to 57 here then, so let's have a little try with that one. Now remember, one of the things that you've found, Harold, is as we've sort of elevated the stroke rate, the necessity to kick really hard is not quite there so much. We're actually just focused on the rhythm of the stroke up at the front. Let's think about that on this next one here. Okay, so 57 strokes per minute, over to you. 16 through halfway. 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 7, 8, 9, and 30. 1, 2, 3. Okay. How was that one? Out of five, yeah.
This time, coming back.
And any specific comments about that one there?
Felt better.
Felt better, okay.
Good job, everybody. Keep working. Remember, this is your workout.
Alrighty. Now, what we're going to do then, let's take it up to 60.
Back at the
well, you probably noticed everybody there, on that last one there, Harold, you don't feel the urge to kick quite so strongly because you haven't got quite so much of a dead spot now at the front end of the stroke. But interestingly enough, the kicking that you were doing was being more effective there as well, as will be evidenced by the times that you're actually swimming. So what I mean by that is less so the legs kicking out of the water, creating a lot of splash, that actually now underneath the water, truly driving you forwards. And that looked like a very, very good lap. Okay, here we go. Let's go 60 then. Okay, ready. Sixteen, 17, 18, 19, 20, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now he really looks like he's swimming. 6, 27, 28, 29, 30, 1, 2. How was that one?
I felt a lot smoother.
A lot smoother. I think we could all agree that that certainly was a lot smoother. Now, being a proper scientific experiment, I shouldn't give you any information back here at all, okay? Interestingly enough, that last lap, he actually took fewer strokes on that last lap than he did on the previous lap. So what we normally expect on a ramp test is that as the stroke rate increases, the stroke itself will start to shorten down a little bit. Interestingly enough, that's been happening over the last few, but on that one there, he suddenly gets not just the benefit of the increase in stroke rate, but also the length of the stroke is actually better than it was on the previous one. That's why he felt so much smoother. And without giving anything away to you, Harold, look at the big difference there in terms of the times. Okay, now we've still got four levels to go yet. We're still gonna get up to Ian Thorpe. Okay, so let's go 63 here, mate. Let's see how we go with this one. Out of 10, how hard was that last one?
Five.
About a five again, okay. All right, cool. Over to you. Fifteen, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22. Look at how effective that kicking is there. 4, 5, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 1, 2. Very nice. Very nice. And how about that one? Even better. Can we agree it looked even better? You're now looking like somebody who's totally on top of their game there. You're swimming very quick, which I'll go through with you in a moment. Okay, and it just looks like you're driving forwards. There's no delay. You've got continuous propulsion. You're truly perpetual in your motion, for want of a better word there, because you're just moving forwards the entire time. You're not stalling by overgliding there. Okay, so let's go 66 now, mate. Out of 10 on that previous one? Still a five, yeah, okay, cool. We're starting to get some heady heights now. It's unlikely that that number would start to go. Again, watch his kick. Look at how much more effective it is. Four, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 5, 6, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31. His stroke rate is going down as his, his stroke count is going down as his stroke rate is going up. Wahoo, indeed. All right, how did that one feel?
Fast.
It was very fast. Okay, it was about 5 seconds, 5.5 seconds per 50 quicker than what we ever saw you swimming on Monday, ever saw you swimming on Monday. Okay, any specific comments? Just felt fast? Yeah, as in a good fast or?
Felt a good fast,
I'm gonna put that in there. Out of 10? About a 6 now, yeah, cool. All right, 69 and 72 then. Take a look at those numbers. Remember, that's indicating there that he's getting, not just faster, but he's swimming much, much more efficiently there the further he gets into this set. Compared to where he was at the start, up here. You're talking 9 seconds per 50 meters difference. All right, per 50. So that's 18 seconds per 100 for somebody who's already swimming at a very, very good level. Okay, are you ready, Harold? Last two, 69. Over to you, sir, when you're ready.
My ketchup is disappearing
as well. Absolutely. 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. He looks like an elite swimmer.
When you go into normal coaching, really focus on that.
All right. How was that one? Starting to get a bit harder now? Yeah, okay. Out of 10? About a 7 on that one. Any specific comments on that one there? No, okay, just a lot harder on that time. Okay, cool. Now, of course, when we do this ramp test, that's exactly what we're likely to find, is it'll go up, it'll get better and better, but then, of course, at some point, it's going to drop off the edge like a cliff. Interesting enough, though, he hasn't started to plateau off with his speed yet. He's still getting faster and faster each time. Okay, 72 now. So imagine this, Ian Thorpe would hold 8 lengths of this pool, 50 meters, at 76 strokes per minute. People confused and thought he was gliding. There is no gliding going on at all at 76 strokes per minute. Okay, especially not when he's taking 10 or 12 strokes per 50 meters more than he can theoretically manage. Okay, so Ian Thorpe can go down a pool like this in 20 or 24 strokes per 50, but when he's racing, more like 32. Much, much more efficient at 32 than at 20 to 24. Much more efficient. Okay, are you ready then? Here we go. When you're ready, last one. Have a little bit of fun here. Let's take it to 11. Ready, 2, 1, and yep. Ten, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 27, 28. Adam can barely keep up. 30, 1, 2. Okay, that's a sub 30 for that last 50. Sub 30 for that last 50. Well done. How was that? Hard? Fast? Now, without a dive there, just ducking under 30 seconds. Just ducking under 30 seconds without a dive. So let's have a little quick look at this then, Harold, shall we? Now, not once during that test did Harold take more than 34 strokes per 50 meters. Your lowest stroke count was 31 on the first two levels. The highest peaked at 34, which is at 57 strokes per minute. But ironically enough, beyond that point, it's all 32s and 33s. Even the last one was 32. Why would it suddenly get longer? Why do you think you'd suddenly get longer in the stroke? We're supposed to be shortening up. Most times when we do this ramp test, people start to take a massive number of additional strokes. Why would he suddenly start to get longer? Catch is improved, but it's not so much his catch necessarily that's improving over the course of the 50. What do we know about the thing that we sort of started off with? The very first thing he said was about his kicking. So his kicking, your kicking is actually now pushing you forwards, okay, as opposed to just being wasted effort trying to compensate for something which is actually holding you back. If you watch the Rio Olympics, Katie Ledecky in the 400, the 800 freestyle, over the course of the 400, her stroke length increases, her stroke count reduces over the course of the, it's because she's gliding more. She's not gliding at all more, her stroke rate's the same, she's kicking more. She switched from a 2-beat leg kick to a 6-beat leg kick, and more importantly, she's actually then getting that drive from behind. So don't be confused when you watch Katie Ledecky swimming. She is not overgliding, not one iota. She's got a beautiful perpetual stroke, and that's exactly what you look like there at the end. That was a brilliant last 50. Brilliant last 50. It got better and better as we went along there. Now, for a little bit of fun then, what we're going to do, you remember that one where we started off at 66, and halfway down the lap, I switched you back to what you were doing on Monday when you presented. Now, it's important to point out that on Monday, you were doing between 50 and 52, and you were doing 50 and 50 between 50 and 52, whether you were swimming steadily or whether you were swimming fast. The difference was when you were swimming fast, you just kicked a lot harder, but most of it was just wasted splash. So what we're going to do now, we're going to have a go from going 66 and at the halfway drop it down to 50, see what it looks like, see what you feel like. All right, here we go. Let's just grab that from you there. I'll go through these numbers with you afterwards, but it's a brilliant, brilliant test. Well done, well done.
I got one here already.
Are you gone? Oh, perfect. Yeah. Cool. Okay, so this is 66 is going to feel quite nice after the 72 that you were just doing there. Yeah. Absolutely.
Let's get that.
That's right. I just peel that down then. Good point. I was trying to put it up to the microphone thinking, why is this not working? And I realised you hadn't got the headset on. Now. Can you hear me coming back through again? Excellent. Okay, so let's make sure we've just got this ready. Okay. Can you hear that there? Okay, so just to the halfway, don't stop at the halfway. I'll just swap it over, transition as quick as you can to the 50. When you're ready, Harold, here we go. Look how beautiful, smooth, and efficient that looks. Now let's go back to his old overgliding stroke. Here we go. His only option is to kick a lot harder. How the left hand comes immediately back in, stalling at the front. But most importantly, we're swimming a lot slower here. This is about 10 seconds per 50 or 20 seconds per 100 slower than what he was doing in that first 25. How was that, mate?
Very weird.
Now, a lot of people talk about this idea that the fewer strokes you take, the more efficient you are. We've even seen a video clip of somebody swimming at a constant speed, claiming that, okay, if I go with a longer stroke and taking fewer strokes, then I'm swimming more efficiently. But what that video fails to show quite clearly is how strongly this swimmer is kicking to actually keep him on the spot. And unfortunately, what we don't know anything about is his breathing rate and his heart rate. We know that now with Harold because we've seen it firsthand. That's exactly what you'll experience yourselves or with your swimmers. If you slow things down too much, watch out for that leg kick. Harold has two choices. Either he slows down, but that's not in his psyche, so he just simply tries to match it with a stronger leg kick, but that wastes a lot of energy. Okay.